lips I cry to you. In darkest places I will call. Incline your ear to me anew, and hear my cry for mercy, Lord. Were you to count my sinful ways, how could I come before your throne? Yet full forgiveness meets my gaze. I stand redeemed by grace alone. I will wait for you, I will wait for you. On your word I will rely, I will wait for you. Surely wait for you till my soul is
Chapter 9, verses 49 to 55. John answered, "Master, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he does not follow with us." But Jesus said to him, "Do not stop him, for the one who is not against you is for you." When the days drew near for him to be taken up, he set his face to go to Jerusalem. And he sent messengers ahead of him, who went and entered a village of the Samaritans to make preparations for him. But the people did not receive him, because his face was set toward Jerusalem. And when his disciples, James and John, saw it, they said, "Lord, do you want us to tell fire to come down from heaven and consume them?" But he turned and rebuked them. Work in progress. When we look at the people we admire today, we see their accomplishments and perfect status of demeanor. We look up to what they had done for the advancement of God's kingdom and their impact today. However, just like those personalities we admire nowadays, we often forget how they were once young, immature people, trying to figure out and learn from their daily struggles. Remember the flawed disciples who journeyed and were chosen by Christ? Peter with his tactless mouth. James and John were called Sons of Thunder because they were feisty, hot-headed, and more. Philip was doubtful and pessimistic, and others. As we take on our Christian journey, we may relate to the disciples who wanted to call down fire from heaven on the Samaritans, only to be rebuked by Jesus. We seem to know a lot because we've been reading the Bible cover to cover for many years now. We seem to know what to do because we believe that we're following the path Jesus took. We seem to be invincible because we have God on our side. However, hurdles easily break our hearts when we encounter them. These kinds of events make us humble. It is also a great reminder that despite our level of maturity, we're still on a journey. A journey that may not end while we are here on earth. Therefore, each time we receive that rebuke or encounter different hindrances, perhaps as long as we are willing to learn continuously, then that's okay. In that way, we will grow. We are a work in progress. Then one day, we will look back and see how God worked in our lives. Prayer. Heavenly Father, we acknowledge a process, a journey that we have to take as you mold us to be emotionally and spiritually mature. It may take a while, but humble us through the process. Guide us daily, Lord. In Jesus' name, Amen.